I was 26 when I joined. The best thing is being able to help those that are in real need. There is no other job that I can think of that I would want to do when you get that satisfaction, when you help out that person, making someone's life better. I literally can't see past this van. Just stop. Just carry on driving. It makes things 20 times harder.
There's
a lot of people.
Yeah, I've seen a couple of 50
Yeah, state 6.
Yeah, it's still behind you, walking away from the ERV up the street. Other.
The CCTV operator identifies the suspect.
Is he the one in the bag? Yeah. Just nicking, mate. Straight up.
Okay. And I fell out. There's been an allegation of assault, OK? So the time is 00:00. Yep, you do not have to say anything, but it may harm your fence. You do not mention, when questioned, something should say or rely on.
All right, please arrest me.
Yep, OK. Yep.
Please arrest me, Thank you.
Arms on your back.
Got anything on you that's going to cause you or me harm?
No, mate.
The person that put the call in had given us a description of the offender and they described him really well. Fortunately, in this situation, the male decided not to run. He went into freeze mode rather than flight mode, which massively helped us.
The assault was witnessed by a doorman.
He hit her and sucked her back to the lock.
Right.
So I grabbed him and drove him out. And he also had her bank card.
Right.
She's been playing straight head open as well.
Okay.
The victim is a wheelchair user.
You alright, my dear?
Yeah, I'm alright.
Yeah. I'm hoping you've got a bit of a headache, but we're going to need to go somewhere a bit more quiet so we can have a chat, if that's alright.
You just take a seat, sit down for me, mind your head.
Can I explain?
Mind your head. You can explain.
Can I explain
you
to
can
you
explain
about my situation?
You can explain in interview, okay? All right? At the moment, really important to separate parties, to give each individual an opportunity to put their side across. Things aren't always as they seem.
Now, who's he to you?
He's my fiancé.
Your fiancé?
He thinks I flirt with men.
Yeah.
I've told him that when I have one too many, I can do. I've told him that straight before I even met him.
Right.
That I can flirt with men because I'm drunk.
Okay.
Then he goes and hits me around the head. And I've now got a massive headache.
Okay.
It was our first day out and he's sporting.
How much have you drunk tonight, fella?
I had a couple of Jack Daniels.
A couple of Jack Daniels.
That's it.
Okay, okay.
I'm not a bad person. I swear down.
Okay.
Yeah, so he's coming with us this evening.
No.
Yeah, he's going to have to, mate. It's been witnessed.
I want him to.
Right. But where's he got that he can go?
My home.
No, he can't come back to your house tonight, mate. He can't.
He can't. Why not? It's my fiancé, for God's sake.
Yeah, but he's already assaulted you, so you two
need some time apart. I want him to come home. Because if I don't have someone at home with me, I can't look after myself.
Is he your carer then as well?
He is. If I haven't got him, I'm basically buggered.
Okay. Disabled people are nearly three times more likely to experience domestic abuse. Sam has to work out if this victim is covering for her partner and carer.
It raises the question, does anything else happen at home? You know, if it quite easily happens out and about in the street, is there more that goes on behind closed doors here?
We went out for our first date. It's just gone funny.
First date? And he's your fiancé?
Yeah. Oh, no, I've been with him for years, but where COVID's been,
yeah.
You can't get out, can you?
Nah. The main thing for me is that is this carer that's supposed to care for her to actually taking advantage of her? Right. Does anybody else care for you at all?
If I don't have him at home, I can't get a dress for him. Big. But at the end of the day, I'm not going to press charges. I'm not going to do anything like that. Come home.
Okay. It's a horrible position to be in, really. You want to give the victim the best that you can. It was one of those instances where either way, I wasn't 100% comfortable with the decision, be it arrest him, bring him into custody, you're leaving a vulnerable female on her own, or not actively seeking to do anything there and then, and then potentially a further incident later on behind closed doors.
Like I said to you, an allegation has been made. You've been arrested for that allegation. OK, all right. If you don't want to listen to me, that's up to you.
No, I am listening to you.
She wants him back. He's her full-time carer. She cannot function without someone else being there.
Response officers Sam and Tom have been called to a domestic incident outside a pub on a busy Saturday night. With the female victim a wheelchair user, she wants her partner to be released.
He's her full-time carer. There is nobody else that can physically look after her.
He's clipped her around
with
the
such
head.
A difficult dilemma, Sam seeks advice from their sergeant.
It's common assault. She's not supporting. You don't fear anymore, do you?
Anything.
Stand at risk. Although there's been an assault, we can justify not arresting as it's time for her care. Okay, cheers, bye-bye. Right, listen to me, mate. She's been told there is one other incident at all tonight. She's going to call us straight away, and this time we'll take you down to custody. What's going to happen for the rest of the evening, then?
Nothing's going to happen, because I'm not an abusive person.
No, and she, quite rightly, she has said that. Most events, there are always two sides of every story. It's all based on evidence that we have, the wishes of the victim in certain respects, and potential for further incidents, which is something that we have to weigh up on every single job we go. You're going to look after her tonight, yeah?
Of course I'll look after her.
Correct. All right.
The time is 00:41, and I am de-arresting you. You are now de-arrested. Right, turn around, lean forward, and I'm going to take these off.
I appreciate it.
We hear of any other incidents tonight, you will be going into custody.
But feelings are still running high.
I know he's.
Where are the darling?
No.
I'm going back to Yorkshire, darling.
What?
Not after what you've done to me. Yes, you have. You got me arrested.
No. Whoa. Come on.
I've just been to the
police
car.
Come up here and talk to me.
Domestics is fueled by emotion. And emotions are really unpredictable. So it is so important that all domestic incidents are taken seriously.
Did you not listen to what my colleague said?
Yes, yeah. I did, yes.
The allegation
but
was made. Listen to me! Stop talking for a minute and just listen.
All right.
Do you hear me?
Yeah.
Are you listening now?
Yeah, I get it.
Good. Why are you laughing?
No, I'm not laughing. I get it.
So you're going to listen?
Yeah.
Close your mouth. Open your ears.
Yeah.
The allegation was made by the bouncers.
Yes.
Okay? They were the ones that turned around and said that they'd seen you hit her.
Yeah.
That was the allegation.
I didn't hit her.
You're not listening. You're really testing my patience right now, okay?
Tom's quite a patient person, generally, having known him for so long. And then even to watch Tom start to lose his temper a little bit with how little he was being understood just shows the reality of what alcohol can do to a person.
Your good lady didn't make the allegation. So you are being released because you are her carer, okay? So you're going home to care for her tonight, all right? You're not going to Yorkshire. Right, good. I've just explained everything that it wasn't you, and he has finally listened to what I've had to say.
Right, so as we said, we have made this executive decision to make sure that everyone's care and everyone's needs are being looked after. Just listen to me, yeah? OK? Mm-hmm. Right? And then you'll both go to the train station, get your train. If there is anything so much as a raised voice between the pair of you, we'll be dealing with it accordingly. Understood? I think seeing how emotive she got at the thought that we were going to take him away and how much that left her with nothing really played an impact insofar as the way that we carried out our work.
Good night.
Good night.
The man was not charged with assault, but the couple were given a referral to social services.